What's good, guys? Medical Gamer over here, bringing you part 6 of our ReCore walkthrough. Now, we met the requirements to get into this place, so let us get to it. Let's get in. Oh, I just realized. This one only needed 4, so this isn't even the one that I needed 6 for. I don't know where the one that I needed 6 for is, but anyways, let's go into the dungeon. Stay close. Here we go. Let's-a-go. It's-a-me. Mario. Not Luigi, but Mario. Cavern Rush. So it looks like there are going to be platforms. Got a platform. Really nice time. Really, really nice time. Color matching increases the damage of any attack, so try to match your attacks with an enemy's color. Too bad we only have the red and the regular bullets, so we can't even match the blue or the yellow yet. Alright, anyways, we have a fast travel station. Oh, you know what? Let's see if this fast travel actually works. Remember, it didn't work in the last video? Okay, it doesn't work now either. I don't know. I have to figure that out. I have to get that fixed, because without fast travel, this game is going to be really, really slow. It worked in the first video, so I don't know why. I'll figure that out and do that later. But luckily, I don't think we need to find that out right now. So let's go. Secondary objective. Oh, complete. What? What? No. I didn't even read it. Oh my god, we need another yellow key. Okay, so another Asian key. And 8 switches, same thing. Jump. Oh my goodness. Oh, this platforming is amazing. This is amazing. I'm sorry, guys. I'm nerding out a lot. Honestly, like, there's nothing super special about this game, but I really do like certain aspects of it, like the platforming, and the combat system is okay. It's not the best, but it's alright. The extraction process is a little bit repetitive, I think, in my opinion. I'll probably bring a review at the very end of playing this game. Okay, so I got one of the switches. I didn't see if I missed anything else, but oh my goodness, that's way too far away. Oh my god, Jewel. There we go. Coming in clutch. Let's go, Jewel. I don't know why those have arrows on them. I'm not sure. Not sure what the resemblance is, but let's keep going. Yo, I think I'm gonna fall. I'm gonna definitely fall at least once. This is pretty hard. So anyways, let's talk about other things not relating to the game, because I feel like in all of my playthrough videos of this game, I've just been talking about the game and what's going on, but that's because I was trying to focus on the game. But now I think I kind of have the mechanics down, so I can focus a little bit less on the game and more on talking about other stuff with you guys. I almost did not make that. Ooh, can I go up there? No, I can't. Okay, but I can shoot that switch. So anyways, today is a Thursday. I'm recording. Oh, no! Oh, no. Wow, just as soon as I started to talk about other things with you guys. Wow. Why did it become all... It became all white. Wow. Okay, whatever. But at least, it didn't really count as a death. Like, it was pretty standard. You know? Oh, my goodness. I made the same mistake again. Ah. Oh well, it's not like I could have met the time achievement anyways, the yellow key and the switches. That would have been too difficult anyways. So made that. So yeah, so today's a Thursday, so I had classes today. So for one of my classes today, we actually had a field trip, a pseudo field trip, which is the very first field trip that I've had in college. It was alright. I wouldn't say it was super, super fun. We basically went to a park kind of, oh my god. How was I supposed to know that one was moving? Anyways, those are checkpoints. That's why they have the arrows. I think that they're checkpoints. All right, well, let's see. Let's see if it moves now. Oh, okay, so it is moving. All right, so anyways, we had a... Oh, no, I have to do dash, jump, jump, dash. So anyways, we had a field trip, and we went to this park, and we observed... So the name of the class is... Evolution of Animal Behavior Lab. So, okay, I have to have patience. I just don't have patience. So anyways, it's called Evolution of Animal Behavior Lab. And what you do in that class is you have these mini field trips. And in the field trips, we go to parks and... Oh, I didn't do the dash. Oh, but I make it anyways. So during the field trips, we get to go to the park. I've said that so many times. But I'm still focusing on the platforming. Whatever. So basically, we go to the parks. And today we observed I'm sorry, guys. I'm really sorry. Today we observed... I'm going to just keep talking, okay? I'm just going to keep talking. No matter what happens in the game, I'm going to keep talking. So today we observed ducks and geese. And basically what we did was we were learning how to do different types of data collection. So the data collection that we did today... Ooh, health boost. The data collection that we did today was... There are multiple data collection techniques for animal behavior and doing... ecology and animal behavior. So basically what we learned was there's something called like focal gathering of data. So focal is basically you look at one at you look at one animal for a period of time and you basically write down every single behavioral state that the animal is in. So let me first just give a few definitions. You know, I don't know if you guys find this interesting, but I'm going to talk about it anyways. Knowledge, you know, while you're playing video games, learning is not a bad idea. Or while you're watching me play video games, learning is never a bad idea. I always, whenever I study for exams and stuff, I'll have TV or YouTube in the background while I'm studying because I find that it helps me. I like to multitask. I like to do multiple things at the same time. Let's go to this place. So anyways, behavioral states are basically things that happen over an extended period of time. It's a behavior that happens over an extended period of time. So an example of a behavioral state would be walking. So like walking could be a behavioral state or an event. So if it's a state, then you're basically saying that the animal is walking. Oh God, get out of there. Get out of there, Jewel. Oh. It's a behavioral state. You're basically saying that it's walking. That's something that it's doing. So like walking, swimming, foraging, like looking for food, or resting. Those are all behavioral states. Now, events are slightly different. Behavioral events are things that are specific things that they do for a set period of time or for like a small, short period of time, such as Let's go with the example of the ducks or the geese. An example of that would be flapping their wings. So that would be an event. Or wagging its tail, that's an event. Those aren't states. The states are things that happens over an extended period of time, you know? I think you guys, you might understand what I'm saying. It was a little bit difficult for me to distinguish between the two at first, but I think that I finally have it down to a certain extent. I mean, it's obviously, I don't know it exactly because this is just the beginning of the class. It's only my second class, second week. But I do understand it to some extent. Wow, this one was like multicolor. I didn't notice that in the other cores. But yeah, so we basically went, we observed the ducks and the first thing we did was the focal data gathering. And that was basically, we looked at one duck and we talked about all of its behavioral states over a 5-minute period. So we basically started with time zero. And so at time zero, it was, let's say it was walking. So at time zero is walking. And then 15 seconds in, it started, it started running. And then 30 seconds in, it started, I have no idea. It started swimming. So those are all different behavioral states, you know? Oh, what do you do here? No idea. Hit those? No. Okay, I guess that's just locked. So, okay, that's locked. Anyways, let's just go down here. And let's return. So yeah, behavioral states. And then the next thing we did was more of a... Let's exit to overworld. More of a continuous... for a group of ducks. So... This is a continuous study of a group of ducks. So, oh my God, I'm sorry. I hit the microphone. You know, this is kind of boring. I'm sorry. I'll try to be more concise and give you guys some more knowledge in a more concise manner. I know I'm kind of beating around the bush because it's hard for me to focus on things I did in class and play this video game at the same time. I'm going to have to get used to that. I'm sorry. I know I'm well into like my first month in YouTube. I've done more than a month. How long have I? Yeah, I've done like a month and like a week or so. Okay, so I want to fast travel, but I can't. I cannot. So let's go to the one. Okay, I guess we have to go back to the one that we already went to. So All right, so let's go back there. So, yep, so the next thing is looking at groups. So you look at groups of ducks and you basically attack these guys. So basically for the groups of ducks, you don't do the same thing because it's impossible to look at all of the ducks at the same time. You know, that's difficult, and record its behavioral states. So what we did was we recorded its behavioral events. So we recorded like the number of times that we picked a specific event, like tail wagging, and you record the number of times that it does that specific event. So the number of times that it wagged its tail. And you do that a total tally for all the birds in the group. Now, the thing where the geese come in is that we needed to do an experiment whereby we compared the ducks to another group of birds, and so we decided to compare it with the geese because there were geese in the same park. So we did that, and we hypothesized that the geese would flap their wings more than the ducks. And the reason that we predicted that was that geese tend to be more hostile than ducks. And so, oh my goodness, get out of here. Get out of here. Okay, yeah, so geese tend to be more hostile than ducks. And so we predicted that they would flap their wings more because it could be seen as like a sign of aggression, you know, flapping your wings towards another fellow creature, whatever it be, a duck or a geese. It's a sign of hostility, you know. Have you guys ever tried to flap your arms at other people? Yeah. They would take it as hostile, you know, just flapping your wings like Flappy Bird. Oh my goodness. So anyways, we predicted that, but we actually found the opposite. So we found that, oh my God, why can't we fast travel? So we found the opposite. We actually found that the ducks flap their wings more than the geese. Now, that's very interesting. Why don't I have a cursor? I have to figure that out. I really do have to figure that out. So we found that the ducks flapped their wings more than the geese, which was interesting because the ducks seemed a lot less hostile than the geese. So that was just something interesting that we noted. Get out of there, break your shield, and attack you, attack you, attack you. So yeah, that was just something interesting, and it was all right. The entire trip took us about like 3 to 3.5 hours. Oh my God, but the funniest thing ever. So during that trip, I thought that we were going to take a school bus to get there. You know, like what you do in middle school, what you do in high school. You take a field trip to get there, you know? Right? Makes sense. Makes sense. No, we did not take a school bus to get there. What happened was our professor actually drove us there, and our professor drove us there in like this super shady van. Like it literally looks like the most shady van that you could find. It's so funny. It's like this dark blue van, really big, tinted windows, all that good stuff. Yeah, it's oh, we already did Pylon 512. I want to go back to the crawler. That's what I wanted to do because Mac is now level 10, so I can equip the level 10 gear. So, oh, can I equip it from the main menu? I don't think so. I think I have to go to the workbench. So, anyways, yeah, that I can't get over the van. It's literally like I don't want to say the word, but it's like a pedophile van. I'm sorry. I try to keep this channel. Oh no, I don't want to talk to you. I don't want to talk to you, Violet. I don't want to talk to you because you can't help me. You can't help me fast travel. Yeah, I like to keep this channel PG, but I had to say it, that it really did look like that kind of van. Oh well. So, anyways, yeah, it was not. Oh, there we go. Our stats are nice now. Type nice. So save loadout. Loadout saved. Research blueprints. Do I wanna invest? Do I wanna invest on anything? Nah. I think Mac is good. Mac is good for now. Mac is P good. Pretty good. So let us go back. Lettuce, tomato, cucumber, onion, pickle, green beans, string beans, other vegetables. So yeah, that's that. That's my shady van experience, my field trip. I know it took me a long time. I basically beat it around the bush, beat around the bush. I think beat is the past tense. So I beat around the bush, and it took me a really, really, really long time to explain that field trip. But, you know, I'm sorry once again. I was kind of focusing on the game, but I did get through the information. I hope you guys kind of understood. You know, I'll try to give you guys a recap. Basically, we did experiments on animal behavior, on ducks and geese, and that's that. That's basically what we did. You know, I want to go to that combat thing. That kind of looks pretty cool. P-chem, physical chemistry. If you guys have taken physical chemistry, let me know, because I have not taken it, and I've heard that it's really hard. But I don't even need to take that class, so I don't even know why I'm asking you guys that. And I'm kind of happy that I don't have to take it, because once again, I heard that it was really hard. Oh, you know what? I don't think I told you guys what classes I'm taking. So let me very quickly go over the classes that I'm taking. So I am taking a class called Evolution of Animal Behavior Lab, which was the class that I just talked about, the one that I went on a field trip for. I am also taking, where do I go? What is this? Oh, that's a log. Can I go up here? No. Oh, I thought I could go. Wait, so where's that combat? I think I have to go around. So anyways, yeah, there's that class. And then I'm taking Ecology of the Dining Hall. Now, that class is actually, I mean, we haven't done very much in that class, but it seems like it's going to be a very, very fun class, because part of the description of the class is that we make frequent trips to the dining hall. Like, that's lit. Like, I don't understand. Like, how can you get much better? Oh, is that radiation? That's going to be radiation. I have absolutely no idea how to get to that combat thing then. Because you can't go up here, and it's, I don't think you can go around here. It's like the end of the map. Okay, whatever. We'll just go to where the objective is telling us to go. As soon as we murk these guys. Let's murk these guys. Oh, I keep forgetting that you can do an instant extract if you, if the enemies don't notice you. So I gotta keep that in mind. Okay, wow, Mac is just gonna destroy that guy. So, Ecology Dining Hall, gonna be lit, because go to the dining hall. How much better can you get than that? So anyways, in that class, basically talking about how we as humans are involved in ecology of like the greater picture, like of the earth, how we fit into the bigger picture of the food chain and all that good stuff. So I'm also taking biochemistry, which, as you guys might know if you are applying to med school, is basically a class that involves learning about the amino acids, about proteins, and all that stuff. It's required for the MCATs if you guys are planning on going into medical school. Now, the actual class itself isn't required for the MCATs, but taking it is recommended because biochemistry is on the MCATs. So like that, the concepts in that class will be on the MCATs. Whether you choose to self-study or take it in college, it's ultimately your decision. I decided to take it because it meets one of the requirements for my major. So I was like, hey, why not kill two birds with one stone? I will get the requirement for the MCATs, and I will also get the knowledge for... No. I will get the requirement for my major, and then I will also get the knowledge for the MCATs. That's what I was trying to say. So, yeah, that was nice, killing two birds with one stone, tackling two things at the same time, all that good stuff. I'm also taking analytical chemistry. Now, the only reason that I'm taking this class is because my advisor said that it was required that even though I AP'd out of chemistry, I am still required to take a chemistry class at my school, which, I mean, doesn't make too much sense for me, but hey, you gotta do what your school tells you to do. And another thing that I'm taking is biophysics, which, once again, my advisor said that even though I AP'd out of physics, I must take a physics class at my school in order to graduate with a biology degree, which, again, like I just said, doesn't really make sense to me, but it's a requirement by the school, so you just have to do... You gotta do what you gotta do, you know? You gotta just suck it up. Honestly, so, like, this semester, I'm taking 19 credits. I'm not sure if all of you guys know what that means. It basically, most classes are worth 3 credits, 3 to 4 credits. So that means that I'm taking, I believe, 6 classes. And, oh, I forgot a class. I'm also taking a PE class, which is individualized fitness, which is basically you get to work out, you work out on your own time, and you record your workout, like your sets, your reps, all that good stuff, and you get to That's a one credit class. And I'm also taking a world religions class, which is online. It's actually a pretty interesting class. Even though it's online, I did some of the readings because even though it's self-paced, I would like to do a module a week. So we have 15-week semesters, and there are... Ooh, there's a loot crate somewhere here. And there are 10 modules for my class. So I would like to just finish it off in the first 10 weeks of the semester so that I have the last 5 weeks off. So I started that class, and it's actually pretty interesting. You learn about, I mean, it's called World Religions for a reason. So you learn about a bunch of different religions, and I'm learning stuff that I really didn't know about before. So it's pretty cool. Pretty cool. So anyways, oh, yo. I never noticed that you could, like, dash and everything even while you're in combat. That's cool. Like, while you're zoomed in, like, not just in combat. So we're going to extract you. Oh, almost. So yeah, those are all my classes. So like I said, 19 credits is 6 classes for me. And if I didn't have to take that biology class, if I didn't have to take that chemistry class and that physics class, I'd only have to take 13 credits, which is amazing. I would have only had to take 4 classes. That would have been so, so nice. I mean, I would have had a lot more free time, but I definitely would have spent that. Oh my god, we just clipped through that. Wow, look at that. Look at that. How nice is that? I would have had a lot more free time, but I would have definitely put in that free time to other things like research and volunteering at the hospital and shadowing and all the things like that. I definitely wouldn't have put my time to waste. So, I mean, that would have been nice. I could have been more productive during that time because honestly, these classes aren't helpful for me at all. Like, they're not required by my major. Like I said, my advisor just said that it was required because I AP'd out of the classes, which, I mean, it's whatever. Like I said, I'm not going to complain again about it. I've already complained enough, I think. So, yeah, that's that. Oh, let me actually go to the objective. All right, so, yeah, that's that. And what else? So, those are my classes. I don't know. What else do you guys want me to talk about? So what else did I do today? So I had that class. I also had biochemistry today. I feel like in my biochemistry class, I'm not really learning all that much in class. I feel like this is going to be one of the classes that I'm going to have to learn stuff outside of class. So potentially read the textbook, but I usually don't like to read the textbook. I usually will just look through the lecture slides and kind of figure things out on my own. And whatever I don't understand, then maybe I'd refer back to the textbook. But I usually don't like to look at the textbook because the textbooks usually overcomplicate things and just, I don't know. I don't really like textbooks. It's not my cup of tea. It's not my thing. Oh, so there's another one. So can we just, like, how, is there an alternate path to get the other one? I'm not sure. Or maybe I have to get all the switches. Maybe I have to get the yellow key. No idea. But anyways, we're about to find out. No turning back now. Yep. You right, Jewel. You was right. You was right, body. So, yep, biochem. Obviously, I have to keep going to the class. I want to stay in the groove. Just go to all my classes. I don't want to skip any classes. Skipping class. Once you start skipping classes, like, that's it. You'll just get into the habit, and it just won't be nice. But a great thing that I heard about med school is that everything in med school is recorded online. So that is amazing because that means that you don't have to go to the lectures. Oh yeah, you have to complete all 3 objectives to get a special reward. Okay, that's awesome. So that is amazing because that means that you don't actually have to go to lecture all the time. So like I can go sometimes, and then sometimes when I'm just not feeling it, like I can just choose not to go. So that would be really, really, really nice, you know? Because sometimes, like, I feel like I learn better when I do things on my own than when I do things in class or, like, with a professor or something like that. So that'd be nice in med school that I can do things at my own pace. I'll still learn everything. Plus, they record the lectures. So they record all the they record the teachers talking. So I don't miss out on what exactly the professors are saying in the class. So, I mean, that's nice. I still get all the information. I'm not missing out on anything. And if I do feel like I'm missing out on anything, I can always try to ask my friends if they go to the lecture. I can always ask them, yo, what's up? What's up? Yo, what's up? So, stuff like that. That's nice. That's a great thing about med school. So, I mean, obviously, if my grades start deteriorating, obviously, start going to class. Like, hands down. Grades are the utmost importance. Med school grades aren't as important, I'd say. One thing about med school is that your board exams, so the MASH A. Okay. The board exams, so those standardized exams, those are the more important things, your performance on that. And then also recommendations that you get from professors. So not professors, professors and other doctors. So those are more important. That's what the residencies look for. And for those of you guys who don't know, the way that it works is you have your undergraduate, so you have college, and then after that you apply to med schools. And then with medical schools, you then have something after that, which is called residency. So residency is basically when you, it's kind of like doing rotations, you follow around doctors, you kind of live like a doctor, but you're not a doctor. You're more like an assistant, but you can do a lot of things that the full-fledged doctors do, which is really nice. You gain a lot of experience. I mean, obviously, they sometimes make you do work that you might think is not the best, but once again, you gotta do what you gotta do, you know? Some things are just necessary in life, and becoming a doctor is a lot of study and practice. I don't know if you guys have seen the Doctor Strange trailer. Doctor Strange is a Marvel superhero, and basically in the trailer, the Benedict Cumberbatch is the main guy. He's Doctor Strange, and he used to be a surgeon before he had like an accident, and he could no longer function as a surgeon. And he tries to gain mystical powers, and so his teacher is like, he's like, oh, like you have to teach me. How can I learn how to do this? And then she's like, how did you become a doctor? And then he's like, study and practice. And she's like, it's the exact same thing. So yeah, a little bit of a Marvel Doctor Strange reference for you guys, in case you guys like that. You know, I like Marvel movies. Hopefully you guys like Marvel movies. I mean, Marvel's great. The DC movies have been okay. They have not been the best, so not really gonna reference them. Is there a place that I can go over here? Can I get up there? Oh, nice. There's a secret area. Secret secrets are no fun unless you tell everyone, and I'm about to go ham, and I mean, there's no one really to tell. I don't know anyone else with this game, so I can't really tell them about this, but I found it. We made it. Oh, loot crate. Don't mind if I do. Jewel. Bejeweled. Bejeweled is a great game, in case you guys have ever not played that game. It's made by PopCap, the same people that made Plants vs. Zombies. Speaking of which, there is an app called Plants vs. Zombies Heroes, which came out in, I think, Australia or something like that. And it's been out since, like, March. But for some reason, they just refuse to put it in the US, or any other country for that matter. I don't know why. I feel like the U.S. should be... Oh, nice, weapon up. I thought the U.S. would be one of, like... I thought they would do an international release, like, a week. Like, a few weeks, maybe, into the thing. Maybe a few months, even. But it's been so long. Literally, the game came out in March, I think. I'm dead serious. I'm pretty sure it came out in March. So, I mean, that's a really, really long time to not release the game internationally. Maybe they don't feel proud of the game. I don't know. Maybe they're still working out the kinks, making it better before they want to do an international release. But like, how long are you gonna take? PopCap is really like, they make really, really good games. I'm not gonna deny it. I love the Plants vs. Zombie games, love the Bejeweled games, love all that stuff. But come on, you gotta speed it up a little. Speed it up. You gotta be like the Flash. You gotta be extra fast. So what's over here? We're gonna extract. What are we extracting? Okay, oh, we did this already, so I don't know, I can't find the other four switches, so I don't know why we're back here. Oh well, is there anything over here? It's a door, looks like a door that doesn't open. My goodness. Alright, well, let's shoot you, and let's get on up, there we go, Jewel, activate that door. Oh no, why did I do that? I was stupid. Wait, what if I just make it in the time period? I think that's something. If I make it in the time period... Oh, I think I already made it in the time period. That's why my thing was unlocked here. Because I made it in the time period. I'm pretty sure. I'm pretty sure. So, let's Go. No, Jewel. Come on, Jewel. You gotta make stuff like that. You gotta make those jumps. You gotta make those leaps of faith. Speaking of which, Assassin's Creed is coming out with a movie. Michael Fassbender. It is coming out pretty soon. I think in December it comes out, which is actually really, really cool. I saw the trailer, kind of looking forward to the movie. It seems like it's gonna be pretty lit. I mean, I don't know. I honestly don't know how the movie is going to be, but it seems like it's not bad at all. Michael Fassbender looks really cool in like the Assassin's Creed stuff, like the gear and all of his assassination techniques and all that stuff in the trailer. So looking forward to that, seeing how that is. And yeah, what was I talking about right before Assassin's Creed? I don't remember. Plants vs. Zombies Heroes right before that, becoming a doctor. Yeah, so oh, medical school. Then you have your residency. So like I said, residency is the thing right after. And residency is basically like it's like the final thing for you. So oh, there's a door up there too. Except I don't know if that door actually opens. Maybe one of those switches opens that door. I don't know. I have to figure that out. So like this switch opens that door. That I know. And then this switch opens. Let's see what it opens. It opens that door. Okay, perfect, perfect. So oh, why did I shoot that one? Can we make it? Can we make it, Jewel? Go, Jewel, go! There we go! Let's go, Jewel. Secrets are no fun unless you tell everyone. There we go, there we go, there we go, there we go. So yeah, residency is basically the ultimate goal in a sense. I mean, there is stuff that you can do after your residency, but residency is like really, really important in that basically where you go can really, really make or break where you actually get a job in. So like there are other things that you can do after, so you can do like surgery and stuff like that, specialization. I personally want to do surgery. I'm thinking about doing neurosurgery, so I will be doing that. I'll be doing the specialization and the surgery. So by all means, oh, I got the yellow key, guys. I got the yellow key. Yay, 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 yay. All right, but I can't find any more switches. Oh, Mac is down there. Oh wait, why did I wait here? I forgot that we were timed for the door. So anyways, it's okay. I can just go right back. Go right back. Go right back. So yeah, so I want to get into like a competitive residency because so like I mentioned, I'm already in a medical program and I'm finishing a year early, so I already know where I'm going to medical school. I don't know where I'm going to residency though, so I really have to focus on my medical school grades, my medical school recommendations, and how I do on the board exams that I was talking about, which are basically like the MCATs or like the SATs, the ACTs, however you want to compare. It's basically the exams that you have to take to become a doctor. So like even if you went to med school internationally, you'd have to come to the US and take those board exams in order to become a doctor in the United States. So that's about that. This episode is pretty long so far. I'm pretty sure we're already at like the half an hour mark, or if we're not, we're very close to the half an hour mark. Now, I got the yellow key. I don't know what that door does. Let's see. What is this? Does it open the side door? No. I don't know what door it opens. That door is open. That door is not open. I thought it would open this side door for sure, but that is just not opening. So maybe that's not an actual door. All right, well let's just get this item now that we're here. Even though we weren't there, it was kind of out of the way. Oh, does it open that door? Okay, well let's see if it opens that door. How are we supposed to make it there that quickly though? That's too fast. Maybe one of our future companions. Okay, it doesn't open that door either. Maybe it opens that door up there where the spider tracks are. That's a very good possibility. So anyways, let's go use the yellow key, see what the yellow key is gonna do, and probably end the episode off there. If it says that I still need to come back here for some objective, then I will definitely, and I'll end the episode off anyways, and I will do this on my free time and not show you guys, because I've already done this place twice. This is the second time I'm doing it, so I don't want to do it again for you guys, because it's kind of boring for you to watch, I imagine. So that's 5 switches. So we don't even have to get all the switches in the time period. The time period is just to get to the end. And I think I already did that. I already did that objective. So I'm pretty sure I did. If I didn't, I will come back and do that, because I can easily do this in under 10 minutes. That's really not too difficult. But the switches, I can't find all the switches. It's just, it's very difficult. It's hard to find those switches, you know? Even though you do have the auto aim in this game is pretty nice. I like it, because I feel like it'd be really, really hard to aim down these robots if you didn't have the auto aim. If you guys know what I'm saying, because... Oh, okay. I remember this. The giant caterpillar, the very hungry caterpillar, the caterpillar that could, Thomas the tank engine, Thomas the dank engine, all that good stuff. Mac, you want to attack the... Can you attack? Oh, Mac can attack. Let's go, Mac. McDonald's. Yo, Mac should be called McDonald's. Oh, that's perfect. In case you guys don't know, McDonald's is a fast food restaurant. They have it internationally, so I'm pretty sure even if you don't live in the United States, you might know. Oh, cost over 10,000 damage in one hit. How did I do that? What did I do for that? Oh, that, yeah, that's the timer. So I did that. The yellow key I did not do. Oh, the yellow key has a prismatic core. So that's perfect. And we did not unlock the other loot crates, but we did get the prismatic core, so that's very, very nice. And we should get the objective from this. Oh. Ooh, access granted. Yeah, I never noticed the rainbow before. This, like, shiny, you know? It's really nice. It's really, really, really nice, nice, nice. All right, so I'm about to just get out of here. Dip, get on out. If Jewel is just too good at climbing. Jewel just refuses to not stop climbing. So anyways, I'm going to try to figure out the fast travel thing if I have time and see if this was actually the last thing that I had to do for this objective, and see if anything else unlocks. But yeah, I'm going to end the episode off here. I hope you guys enjoyed the video. If you did, please hit the thumbs up down below. I know it was a little boring at first, especially just talking about my field trip, but I hope I made it a little bit more interesting for you guys, talking about other things like med school and residency, all that good stuff. And yeah, that's about it. If you enjoyed the video, please hit the thumbs up down below. It really helps. Subscribe. All that good stuff. Tell your friends about it. Spread the word. Spread everything. Just kidding. Don't spread everything. Like STDs. You don't want to spread that. Those are really bad. Anyways, I'm going to get out of here. Peace.